Hi, folks, and welcome to another Three Stooges review.
And this one is Pardon My Scotch.
This is the ninth film they did with Columbia Pictures.
And we have what would become the familiar theme music. Now, this is the first one of the shorts where we have what will become the Three Stooges theme music.
This is another one directed by Del Lord, and it was written by a guy named Andrew Bennison. This one starts off a little slow, in my opinion, but once it gets going, it definitely earns a 3 for slapstick comedy.
It's a fun slapstick episode. There's saws and hammers and blowing up things and stuff, so it's good.
Yeah, and this one actually uses a lot of what I would term trademark Stooge routines. We have the Stooges as carpenters, which we'll see again. We have them as pharmacists, which we'll see again. We have them mixing potions, which we'll see again.
And we have them as Scotsmen, which we'll see again.
That's right. I didn't even think of that. And we have them mixing with high society, which we'll see again, which is probably one of the strongest Stooge story elements you can come up with.
That's when the Stooges are at their best. There's nothing better than the Stooges mixing with the high society. I mean, that's just a plan for failure and a plan for hilarity. I give the dialogue a 3.
I also give the dialogue a 3. This is a very funny episode with a lot of funny jokes and a lot of interesting dialogue. There's a legendary story about Moe fracturing a rib during a scene, and he actually completed the scene, even though he was probably in great pain. But I don't recall the details of what episode this supposed incident took place.
But I'll tell you what.
There is a stunt that Moe pulls on his own that certainly qualifies for this injury to have taken place.
Yeah. I don't know what he was thinking about doing this.
Right. Well, when he got up, he was definitely not a happy camper. I mean, you can clearly, I mean, whether he fractured a rib or not,
it doesn't matter.
Obviously, this hurt. The plot is actually a little bit convoluted to just explain verbally quickly, but suffice it to say that the Stooges pose as liquor distillers. How do I put this? All the characters are in a situation where they're forced to rely on the Three Stooges.
Right, right.
Which is, being in a situation where you're forced to rely on the Three Stooges is...
is a plan for hilarity.
Right. Yeah. So that's why this plot definitely earns a 3, and I think that's why. I think this is probably the quintessential Three Stooges situation, where high society people are forced to rely on the Three Stooges to get them through a situation.
Right.
That's, you know, a recipe for hilarity.
Yeah.
And all of the better Stooges films have that in common. That is not to say that all of the better Stooges films
it's just that when
require
they, when,
that. But
when they implement this element, I can't think of a bad Stooge episode where they mix with high society. I know a lot of them.
That plot device is always a winner, is what we're saying. And so this marks, I believe, the first time that this is introduced. This is film number 9. So moving on, speaking of people depending on the Stooges and whatnot, the supporting cast does a very fine job in this.
Yeah, I like everybody.
Yeah, everybody's good. So the Stooges also themselves, individual performances. Oh, wait a minute. Are we doing this right? I'm just saying, are we doing this right? I mean, for slapstick comedy, I give it a 3.
I give it a 3.
For dialogue, I give it a 3.
I give it a 3.
For plot, I give it a 3.
I give it a 3, too.
Supporting cast, 3.
Yeah, definitely.
Individual performances by the Three Stooges?
3-3-3.
Pretty girls? There's no pretty girls in this.
Well, what can you do? You can't have a perfect episode. We'll see if we get a perfect Stooge episode. We'll see, right?
I will say, if I didn't mention it, that this is one of those Stooge films that I did not realize was one of my favorites or one of their really strong episodes.
And remember, when you're watching this is really early in the short's career. This isn't... I think a lot of us, and the reason why we're doing this is because I don't think, as all the years watching this, I don't think I realized how early Pardon My Scotch was. I thought, you know, probably, Pardon My Scotch was probably when the whole act was solidified and they knew exactly what their characters were going to be and everything. But that's actually not that true.
on the other hand, what this demonstrates is that they were, and that they had writers getting on board who knew exactly what to do with this act.
Right, exactly. Because before this, if you remember, if you go back and look at the other reviews, we're wondering if the writers know what they're going to do with the Stooges.
Exactly, but our last, let's see, from film seven is Pop Goes the Easel, eight is Uncivil Warriors, and nine is Pardon My Scotch. So this is the third one in a row that is absolutely funny and entertaining just in general. My total score is a 22.
And my total score is a 22.
The only mark this misses is the pretty girls. There's just no hot chicks in this, that's all.
Yeah.
Other than that, it's a perfect episode, and
see it.
I never knew that before. I just think that's so cool that here we are doing the chronological thing, and now I know forever that Pardon My Scotch is the first episode to use some of the strongest plot devices and routines that the Stooges have ever done.
Not to mention the classic theme music.
Right, it's like everything has finally come together. Now, how long can they hold this up? Because we know that out of 181 more shorts, they can't be, they can't all
they
be
can't
good,
all
right?
They can't all be Pardon My Scotch.
No. All right, so our next review, speaking of which, is Hoi Polloi.
Yeah, Hoi Polloi. And we won't say a thing about it until...
Yeah, I want to say some things about it, but we shall say more about it when we actually do the review.
Right.
So... do yourself a favor, rate and subscribe. So do yourself a favor.
And us.
So do yourself a favor.
What do you mean, right, left?
So do yourself a favor.
And us.
Rate, comment, and subscribe.
We'd love to hear from you. It's the truth.
To the Three Stooges review. You know what? I know. I got a question for these people. Yeah. We don't watch TV anymore. Long stories aside, we don't watch TV anymore. Are the Stooges on? Are they on television? Tell us about it.
Yeah.
Are they on weekdays, weekends?
Prime time?
Are they on in the middle of the night? Yeah. What's going on?
Are they just local? Are they cable? We are genuinely curious. I wonder about that.
All right. So we'll see you next time with a review of Hoi Polloi on the Three Stooges Review.
See ya.